Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem of New Zealand to be sung by Russell Harrison.
And the New Zealand national song, and now the crowd are ready to watch some footy. This is what we've been waiting for a long, long time, the start of this Lions tour.
Oh, it sure is. The anticipation, absolutely huge. Wee bit of fire early on. I'm sure there's Paul Honus, the referee. He's vastly experienced. He's looked early for a bit of fire from Bay of Plenty, and how the Lions react to it with controlled aggression.
And the referee for tonight's DHL series match is Paul Honus.
So Sims Davison there. There's Alan Bunting, who was in doubt earlier in the week. Had a broken thumb. Took the cast off on Tuesday. Wasn't going to miss this for anything. And we'll pick up these Lions players as the match progresses. As Drakey said, Paul Honus, the referee tonight. Steve Walsh and Kelvin Deeker are the touch judges. And Paddy O'Brien sitting upstairs, should he be required. The television match official, Bernie Upton, who made such a big impression during Super 12 with the Chiefs. Ronan O'Gara from Ireland has the ball, and he will get this tour started. The Lions have the advantage of a light breeze, which is going right to left in this first half. And the 2005 Lions tour is underway as O'Gara makes the kickoff. And it's taken in for Bay of Plenty by Burke. Senio goes for a quick dab. He didn't have anyone to give it to. And so they have to reset it. Lob back. And the kick, clearing kick, is made by Murray Williams. And the first line out of the tour will take place just out from the 22.
An orthodox start from the Lions. Kick off all their forwards to one side. They chased hard. Senio saw a gap, but the experience of the Lions, they fill up round the rucks and the mauls. First touch for Williams at first five out from Bay of Plenty. He got into touch well. Didn't go a long way, but he got it out, and that's important.
The only Scotsman in the team tonight is Gordon Bullock, the hooker. And he'll throw to the lineup. Targets Ben Kay and Paul O'Connell, the Englishman Kay. O'Connell, the Irishman. And of course, Delalio further back. And the first lineout is not contested. Taken down by Kay. Here is O'Driscoll running hard at the line. Over the 22 he goes. Now it's Peel off to Delalio. And the Bay of Plenty defence called on in the early stages as they stay on the blind side. And Henson takes it in. But just 15 metres short of the line here, once again, Peel, the halfback. Ripped across by O'Gara. Now Shanklin and the big lock forward, Paul O'Connell. And this is a great start by the Lions. They're moving them right and left. And Bay of Plenty having to make some big tackles early on. Coming slowly again for Peel. Now he gets it across to O'Gara. Here's a chance. And the first try of the tour is scored by Josh Lucy.
Oh, a great try. Right from the line out, unopposed. O'Driscoll in midfield. So the secret of this try was breaking across the advantage line at will. Sure, Bay of Plenty were tackling them, but the damage already been done. And they got a lot of quick ball. They turned it in a couple of times, but in the end, when they went it wide, they really had them stretch. Pace beat them in the end. Look on the inside here. This was probably the slowest ruck ball that they had in this phase, but it was still quick enough, and they had enough depth. Big wide pass here. Then the skip, and look at that. That's just pace through the outside. Bay of Plenty winger had no idea. Smithy, great start.
Yeah, great start, and the skills early on. Drakey of the big tight force, Delalio handling twice. I've never seen a player so fired up before a kickoff as Lawrence Delalio, and he was straight into the action. Mistake-free rugby by the Lions, the perfect start.
There's O'Gara's first kick at goal, and it's going to stay out to the right. But the early damage has been done by Josh Lucy, the fullback, a sometime winger, and it was the cutout pass from O'Gara that did the job here. Just put Lucy into the gap, and in he goes.
Interesting use too, Drakey, of a decoy runner out wide there just before the last pass was made. And that's something that the Lions would have noticed about the Super 12 and even the trial last night.
Williams makes the kickoff, goes down to Delalio. Mark Quetta on the right wing for the Lions.
Six come out, he's okay, play off.
Back now for O'Gara, deep inside his 22, that's a lovely kick. Spiralling down to Colin Burke, who gets it in quickly. Cashmore moves it across. Keen to get the game going at pace too, Bay of Plenty. Just a little bit slippery, but a good effort by winger Bolobuthu as he had to go back and recover it. Just on the Bay of Plenty side, halfway in there, offside.
Retiring player, rocket form, retiring player offside.
And Paul Honus dead right, Bay of Plenty.
Number three, retiring player.
Yes, a couple of mistakes really. Bay of Plenty and caught out, and the pace of the game I think is one thing that the Lions are going to try and do tonight. There was talk before the game that they were going to try and get quick ball and spread it wide. Well, they can do that, but they've also got the big men to go up the middle, and that makes the defence, it stands it up, it makes it compact a bit, and that creates a space out wide.
So no attempt at penalty goal there by O'Gara. And you can see the Bay of Plenty player coming in here, clearly offside. I think it might have been Ben Castle. The ruck had already formed. Throwing deep to the back, and I think it went to Martin Williams, who wasn't really expecting it. But they've got it successfully. Peel looking left and right. Gives it off to O'Gara, another cut-out pass. Henson having a go. And not afraid to have a crack at the defence in midfield, both Henson and O'Driscoll. Peel, they're getting all the ball so far, the Lions. Bullock gets hit hard, absolutely smashed. I think it was Nili Latu who got him, but they've still recycled it. O'Gara, quick hands, looking to O'Driscoll. Just running out of room, but he's got good support from Tom Shanklin. And the big Welshman is only 7 or 8 metres short of the line.
They got Richard Hill way out left.
Very impressive start this. Yes, he's lurking way out on the left. There's a chance here for Williams. And Lucy has another go at the corner. And he's going to go upstairs and have a look here. So Paddy O'Brien will come into action. I think Josh Lucy thinks that he managed it okay. We'll have to wait and see.
Oh, yeah, they're all heading back to halfway. And he did that. He actually went on the outside. And you're right, Smithy, he had Hill on the outside of him. He could have just straightened it up. That's a fair try for me. The only thing you could say is maybe his leg before it goes down and the last shot before it showed it. Or maybe his front arm.
Yeah, maybe the left elbow. But we're really clutching at straws. The Lions deserve this try. But it's that last angle that may hang Josh Lucy.
Oh, yeah.
It's tremendous skill in the tackle to do what he did, really. But left arm, point of contact, I think that's a try.
So do I. So we've got to have a look at the leg again, I guess, and if it's at that speed, if it's very slow, you'll actually see it. That's his left leg. Does the knee? No, I think he gets it down. But we'll leave it to Paddy again. He's paid to do it. What the Lions, they started off going back to halfway, but they're on the 22 at the moment, so they're not maybe 100% sure themselves now.
Either way, Drakey, what a magnificent start.
Oh, it was superb.
Just the play that they've exhibited, the pace they've been playing at. They look like they're just as keen to get this tour started as we are to wait for it.
I think he just made it, Drakey.
Yeah, so do I. Split second stuff.
Just gets it down, I think, there. Before that left elbow hits the line. So let's see what the decision is.
Okay, yep. Thank you. Time on.
Try given. Second try to Josh Lucy. And the fullback is struck twice inside the first 6 minutes of the game.
I think this is where, Bullock gets hit heavily. Oh no, this is the end of it. You can just see the structure of their game, Smithy, already starting. They spread it wide and then they leave their forwards out in midfield, get over the advantage line and go for the quick ball, and it's working pretty well so far in this tour.
O'Gara's kick this time is to the left, but this man, Josh Lucy, who made his debut against the All Blacks back in 1998, has made a great start. He is a winger, has been a winger, and he knows how to finish in the corner, and he did it expertly there. 10-0, 2 tries by Lucy as Richard Hill takes the kickoff. And they've had all the ball so far, the Lions. O'Gara bangs it off down towards halfway, and this really has been an impressive start.
And that's one thing you've got to say about the Bay of Plenty side. They got it at the first kickoff, then they got it again from a kick to touch, which didn't go, and they kicked it away. They can't afford to do that anymore. You've got to keep the hands on the ball and just build up some phases. Sure, that's what Wayne Orman, the skipper's, told them.
Aleki Latui to throw. Not a good start. Waters on the line side. And Peel gets it off again to O'Gara. The midfield bomb coming forward to meet it is Anthony Tahana. And he's been in a good tackle by Henson. But the Bay have it. Williams. And a wobbly old kick downfield. And a successful one made by Grant McCoy.
Ominous at the last line out though. Lions contesting. They've got a lot of tall timber. They might be going for a short one this time. They're just mixing it up a wee bit.
Another good line out. They're big men, aren't they?
Got no halfback, so they're going to have to keep on driving this.
Ward just looking to sneak around the blind side, but running out of room there. So he gives it off to Peel. O'Gara gets it wide for Henson. And the pin-up boy of Welsh rugby belts it off downfield. Not handled well by Cashmore. Vastly experienced player, of course, is Adrian Cashmore. O'Gara calls
on
for
me,
the mark.
Gold, gold on me. 15, come back 15.
Ronan O'Gara gets first crack at that number 10 jersey tonight. Of course, Johnny Wilkinson lurking. So also Stephen Jones, the Welshman. All the bases are covered. Quickly thrown.
Drakey, first impressions are that the Lions want to use every blade of grass in terms of the width of this park. On that occasion, it was the big lock. Paul O'Connell stretched right out to the left here, just in case something was on.
Yes, well, a very structured side, and their patterns are obvious already. Very well drilled, as you'd expect.
Once again, contesting the Bay of Plenty throw. And they're just not getting it right at the moment, Bay of Plenty, as it goes to Henson.
Knocked
down by O'Driscoll in a mistake in the midfield. And so we go to a scrum, first one. Drakey, this is your point of interest.
Yes, well, let's hope the scrum goes a wee bit better than the line-out is at the moment. There's O'Driscoll, he is flat-footed, and he probably saw a bit of Nililato in the corner of his eye. So it's a great position for Bay of Plenty. Midfield, they can go either way, but they've got to get the set pieces right.
Hold.
They're not going well at line-out. A couple of Super 12 props in there. So they just want to stabilise it. Not too bad at the moment.
Holding nicely. Awkward transfer, though, and it's been upset. Dallaglio gets his pass off, and now they're a chance wide to Shanklin. Oh, easily beat Bolobuthu. And look at the power here of the Lions as they get down almost to the goal line. And Peel gets it wide. O'Gara's going to kick. And oh, it must be a try. And it is a try. An easy try to Mark Cueto out on the right wing side. And what a good kick by Ronan O'Gara. And the Lions at the moment are rampant.
Oh, great vision. Came from a mistake at the scrum. Colin Burke, it was a steady scrum. He just fumbled it a wee bit. Senio went in front of him. Here we go. Look at this. So he was upset by Peel. Senio, no chance. Look at the numbers that they're getting, though, the Lions. Oh, great play from O'Driscoll behind his back. Shanklin, well, Colin Boothby wasn't even there. Look at the strength here, though. Just driving on. And again, very, very quick ball. Bay of Plenty were all offside. It didn't really matter. Look how bunched they were in midfield. Bay of Plenty. No difference. The Lions had three players on the touchline. Any one of them could have scored it.
Completely fooled by a penny by these tactics of the Lions playing the game so wide. Three tries, two in the left-hand corner, one in the right, just by using the width that they have and them being switched onto the game plan totally. Bay of Plenty being caught, bunched in midfield, expecting a midfield drive. Not to be. Great vision by O'Gara, great finishing Cueto. What a start.
O'Gara trying to kick his first goal of the tour, and he's managed one. So three tries already, one converted. And the majority of this crowd are shocked.
Well, this is the end of it. So we're going to get the penalty anyway. Now, there's daylight between the two teams at the moment. It's for your guide possession. It's about 100% to nothing at the moment. It's not really. It's 86-14, but it might as well be 100.
Taken down by Richard Hill, the vastly experienced Englishman who's had his injury problems. And O'Gara again. So they play to a pattern, nothing flash, but inside the 22. And O'Gara's driven play back towards halfway.
Oh, why wouldn't you want to kick it out when you've won every line out of the game so far? Plenty going short, so that's going to try and eliminate the jumpers.
Wayne Norman gets it. Off it went to Sorensen. And now the Bay gets some ball. And a nice dab here in midfield by McCoy. Gets the ball from Bunting. Trying to keep in the field of play, which he's successfully done. Senio. Difficult pass for Grant McCoy, but he hauled it in. Now Senio clears it off to Williams. Short pass, but big defence on Sims Davidson. But he's managed to hang on to it. Now the Bay getting a bit of ball. They look a better side. Senio once more. Kicked through by Cashmore. And Aquino gets knocked over. And he wants the ball. He wants it desperately, does Tahana.
Yeah, it's a penalty.
And he deserves it too.
The ball.
So interesting here. They got a bit of fire up in the moment. It's the first phases they've had, Bay of Plenty. What do? Settle it down. Take the points, I'd say. Way behind, but you got to get start. You got to start the scoreboard clicking. Oh no, he's going to go for the corner, is he?
Well, the Lions are contesting the lineouts. It'll be interesting to see whether they do here in a defensive lineout. Now, this was silly stuff here from Mark Quiddo. Tried to help hold the ball, and Anthony Tahana had every right to go for it. Well taken down by Upton. Now they're going to try and muscle the Lions. Back it comes to Senio. Williams having a bit of a dab.
Roll off.
Crowd now starting to get in behind them. A crack by Bunting. Good tackle though by Henson. Wayne Norman in at halfback. He's going to go himself, the captain.
Back out, one red, go.
Now they get it off to Williams. Latu, oh, good work. Latu got the pass off to Colin Burke. And the Bay of Tahiti are in through Colin Burke.
Well, they took the risk. They didn't go for the shot at goal. The line-out worked for them. The ball was very slow. There's some good skills from Latu in the end to put it around the corner. The Bay of Plenty go for a bit of width as well. They've learned off the lines. But this was a pretty slow ball. Williams does well. Well, that's a very average from O'Gara. The winger comes in. It's a straight run for Burke into the corner.
Yeah, it's an interesting method of defence. They were up so quickly, and then they just started to slide sideways, and that was a very easy fend. You'd expect better from that, and then Delalio was a bit laboured getting across himself, so Colin Burke, the opposite number, had the line at his mercy. The Bay of Plenty last year showed a tremendous amount of fight. That was their trademark. They've been stung, but the bounce back is only they can do.
Well, Smithy, it'll give them some confidence too, because the pace of the game, I think, has been a bit beyond them so far. Started to get some phases, and they'll get used to it. They'll get into the game.
Big task here for Murray Williams. Glenn Jackson was in that number 10 jersey last year. Williams has brought it in, though, beautifully. And so the converted try, scored by Colin Burke, the highly promising number 8 forward. He spent time at the Highlanders this year. The hard work, though, done by Nili Latu. Copybook stuff. And Burke there to finish off.
Oh dear. Man in front, long kick. Oh sorry, no, he's got him for kicking the ball. Is it over the mark? Over the line? Might just have a quick look at that again.
That's Paul.
You can just see that he's way over the line, so he would have told him beforehand. One for the referee's assessors, Book Nisbah.
It is. Yep.
Crouch and hold.
Good opportunity here for Bay of Plenty again. Last scrum was solid, although it got upset at the back.
Red three, too early.
Too early against Matt Stevens. So away goes the try scorer.
Hands off, red rock.
Colin Burke. And they're getting a bit of ball now, Bay of Plenty. Here's Latui, loves to run. Crunching his way downfield.
Hands off, 13.
Gets it wide to the captain, and Wayne Orman places it immediately. Senio for Williams, looking for runners. But the Lions' defence is pretty solid. Senio goes again. Sorensen, not making a lot of progress here. Sims Davison has a real crack at Gordon Bullock. Pushes him back a metre or two. Now they go with Orman. Senio once more. Williams, now they look as though they're going to spread it. Now here's Bunting. Chased across and taken by Henson, and a good tackle. Williams got there quickly, and so also is Ben Kay, the big lock forward. They're getting their big men across the park pretty quickly.
Well, it had to be a penalty in the end. Dalio's going to object. Player on the ground.
10 metres, please.
No argument.
No point. So this has been a good 5 minutes for the Bay of Plenty after conceding those three tries very quickly.
He's a young man. He stepped into Glenn Jackson's shoes, pretty big to fill, and he's impressed me so far. You just saw in that last phase where he could have turned it inside and decided not to. There's the Lions player on the ground. Lalo's trying to trap it and block it off, so I think you could get it both ways.
Latui going short to Sorensen. Here's Burke. Can't get past the tackle of Williams. Ormond back for Williams again. McCoy. McCoy trying to bust through the tackle of Odisco. Coming for Senio now. Here's Latui. Get out of my road. Josh Lucy goes back. This is more like the Bay. There's a player flat on the deck. It's a Lions player, but we'll have to carry on just for the moment. As Bay of Plenty probing away.
Got numbers.
Got a chance. Out to Burke again. And the ball has been lost. And the Lions in control of it.
Accidental offside.
Nispo, let's go back to the injured player because it's crucial. It's Dallaglio and he's in a bad way. He's had his hands on his head. They're looking down at his knee and they've already given the substitution sign. They're not going to muck around with him.
Yeah, OK.
Oh, no. This is the end of it where Burke goes through and I think he throws 50-50 pass, hoping that someone was there. It wasn't. So there was a knock forward first from the Lions. And then he's got another Lions player for offside. I'm not sure who that was. Here's Latui. That's Lucy just goes for Miles. Dallaglio, does he come across here or was it in another phase? You can't see it there.
I think it was the phase earlier to the left, Drakey, he got involved in. But it's straight away, they've gone for the cart to carry him off. It doesn't look too flashy. It looked like he grasped it either down at his ankle or his knee and then he put his hands to his head. So much experience, they'll be very nervous up the top there.
Pretty sure it's an ankle, Smithy.
Martin Corrie in jersey 19, no doubt about him coming on this bow anyway.
Well, they're holding that ankle.
There he is arriving at the top of your screen and slips.
Oh, he slips. Yeah. And he didn't get up. That's terrible. Oh, no.
Yes, he just lost his footing completely.
That looks bad.
The boot off already. Well, no, it's not, is it? But definitely that right ankle, and he's in some pain.
There's a lot of concern on the bench, as you would imagine. So instrumental into the thinking and to the mindset of these new players in this Lions side tonight in particular, but also the whole squad.
Well, he's on his third Lions tour. We know that he didn't play Six Nations. He retired from that. 73 caps for England. You can't buy that sort of experience. And naturally enough, Brian O'Driscoll, the tour captain, is greatly concerned about it.
Sorry, 21 gone.
He's a real warrior. The guy you'd always want to have in the trenches with you. Let's just hope it's not as bad as it looks.
Well, he looks concerned too, Sir Clive Woodward. You're always going to get injuries on tours like this, but to lose a key player after 20 minutes, now we're not saying, are we, that it's the end of the tour, but boy, it looks pretty serious. And we're hearing a dislocated ankle.
And in such an innocuous kind of way, because he was just, you know, just slipped, literally. So the game stops while we wait for this, and rightly so, but the players only want to keep their concentration up there.
There's Martin Corrie there, just to the right, just got out a shot. He'll take Dallaglio's place at number eight. He is also a highly experienced player. Colin Burke, the try scorer for Player Plenty.
Just try and come down a little earlier. Just don't go out too long.
So Martin Corrie with 37 English caps, plus three on the tour to Australia for the Lions in 2001. So he's a very experienced player, but the Lions were very sad to lose this outstanding player. So Dallaglio leaves.
Back it off, Red.
And we'll just have to wait and see whether that is the end of his tour or not. Meantime, play continues. The Lions produce a pretty big scrum. Burke, though, hands it off. Now it goes into centre field for Tahana.
10.
And there was some obstruction there. And it was against number 10, Murray Williams, who cut across
in front
of the player with the ball. O'Gara takes it quickly and bangs it off downfield. Adrian Cashmore hasn't got many options available to him other than to clear it for touch.
They had a lot of time to talk about that move, Drakey Bayapeni, but I think they had one too many dummy runners, and one of them took out Gavin Henson.
Well and truly. Missed opportunity. Lions will get the ball back now, and they won't want to give it up again.
Obviously, Ben Kay is the man calling the shots in the lineouts. So the Scotsman throws. And it's a bit short. It's got Senio under pressure, though. But the Bay have got back pretty well behind the ball here. Looks like Nili Latu might be the halfback. And he's well contained down the blind side. Now Ormond. Nice burst away for Latui. And he couldn't stay in the field of play.
In five,
but they have some physical players, the Bay. They like to take the opposition on. Blokes like Latui, Ormond, Latu, Burke.
It's just maybe the body position's a little bit high. Good defence from the Lions down the narrow side.
The game already has settled down after that initial onslaught by the Lions. Well, they scored three tries inside the first 15 minutes.
Try and hold it steady, fellas. Put closer, crouch and hold.
A bad scrum from Bartlett. They're trying to angle into touch. Very hard to do.
Engage.
The tight head to come up.
Dwayne Peel, the Welshman.
Keep it on.
Corrie is the new man in the number eight position. O'Gara gets it wide. Here's O'Driscoll, creating a bit of a gap for Lucy. The fence cuts him down, though, in the form of Bolabuthu. But it's there again for Peel. Now O'Gara. Big charge in the midfield from Kay. And the Lions might have turned this ball over.
Latu
first there. Now Castle. Passing's a bit laboured, but Latu can be expected to straighten it up, and he does so.
Back
now for Williams to make the clearance. And not out. Nicely taken by Quito. Infield it goes to Lucy, the man who scored the two tries. And the Cashmore let it bounce. Probably felt that he just couldn't quite make it on the full.
He wanted to get the throw in for his team.
A couple of good barging runs from Aliki Latui, but now the acid goes on and his accuracy has to be spot on with his throw.
Time just off, that guys. Last move from the Lions as well. You saw O'Driscoll on the outside. He beat Bunting on the outside and set up the pass for the wingers and fullback. Bunting got him in the end, but he tackled him after the ball. There he is there, so he's got his hands full tonight. Pretty good sevens player.
Matt Stevens down this time for the Lions, Nisbo.
Yeah, I think he's put one on, Mark Corrie can put the contacts back in.
The first couple of lineouts, Bay Plenty lost, and then a bit of reverse there. Wasn't the tidiest ball for Senior, but it allowed them to get back in the game. A short line out here for Bay of Plenty.
We've
got too many numbers, the Lions. Throw it in quickly, Bay of Plenty, you'll get the penalty.
It goes to Latu.
Well, that's high risk stuff, isn't it?
Isn't it just? He's slow. Oh, he's deep in his in-goal area, Williams. He's done pretty well to get it that far downfield. In fact, he's done very well. What a kick.
Watching.
He wouldn't have believed that was possible, really. It was a scramble, but he's got it almost to halfway.
Oh, the vagaries of the football. Tom Shanklin, he is waiting for it, and it just scooted past him.
15 minutes remaining, first half, 17-7.
Lions, get your call in earlier or free kick for Borkins. Wasting time. Last chance, let's do it properly.
Well, he's let him off with a warning. Corrie is the lineout taker on this occasion. Oh, that's great work.
Burke again.
Advantage goal.
The Lions had the ball out there and said, why don't you have a crack at it? And sure
no
enough,
advantage.
They did.
Ross Ford, it red, scrum down goal.
Poor technique, really, by the Lions.
Well, they had the ball. They got sacked at the line out very quickly. Corey went up, I think it was. They had it under control. Here's Burke. He just shipped. Well, if anything, I think Hill actually thought it was one of his own players grabbing the ball.
Engage.
Pretty useful scrum from the back line. As Senior gets it off to Williams. Lobs it up for Bolabutu, who's got a ton of pace. But he's well contained right on the halfway line. Now they get it back. Williams again goes short to Upton. And this big man plows into Lions territory. Senio. Latu losing his footing.
Hands off,
Red! Heavy Jew falling on the ground. And
Ruck was formed.
Hands in
hands,
the ruck.
Red 13. Ruck was clearly formed.
Against the skipper.
Players are bound on you. Ruck is formed. 10, please. 10, please.
No point objecting.
Well, he says he's the tackler, and I don't think he says that there's enough players from his team to make it a ruck and a maul, but it's pretty hard to argue against Mr. Honus. A lot of people have tried. I don't know anyone who's won.
Drakey, what they are using now, Bay of Plenty, is the blind side very well to their advantage, particularly on the left-hand side there. They may think that Kuwaito is a bit of a weakness there, but they've been plugging away there, particularly the loose forwards, the likes of Latu, and also we've got Ormond working away at the left there.
Yes, and they're giving the ball a lot of space out that way too.
Upton goes high again. Senio for Williams. Lions defence in close has been pretty handy. Here's big Ben Castle. Over the 22 they go. Ball pops back again for Senio. He's dangerous on the burst.
He's fine.
Very nearly wriggled his way through.
Lay on.
Cashmore off to Williams again. McCoy, Latui. Hard man to hold, but they do. Ball still there though for Bay of Plenty. Putting some real pressure on. 5 metres away. Ormond pops the pass to Senio. He gets it away. Good hands. I think it was Williams. Senio goes again. Latui to Ormond. Ormond close. Just a metre short. Now they have another crack. Ball is right there. Senio, did he lose it forward? I think
double
he might have lost it forward
first. Goal. Second by goal. Yes.
Well, he said the first one was the Lions. Oh, I don't know.
No, he said two knock-ons, they're both by the same team. I thought it was, though. I thought he just juggled it right at the... He got the call there from Steve Walsh. I would have thought Orman would have done...
Is that right?
Well, he had to get it from behind, I guess. And Smithy, it was Cueto who actually got him around the ankles, and that was important.
It was really important because it's obviously the plan of attack there. They are using the 5 or so metres on the left-hand side very, very often indeed. And that was just a genuine fumble. Without the touch judge, I think he might have got away with that. But you can just see now the Lions have, I think they've realised the party's over in terms of this match. It's down to hard work all of a sudden. Two or three of them just bent over a wee bit. They've lost the inspiration in the pack in the form of Delalio. So O'Driscoll's going to have to come in and be a little bit more instrumental in that area, perhaps.
Ben Kay came over the top and it was his big mitt which spoiled the ball. Bit of heat on here at scrum time.
Engage!
Oh, hello, he's given it to...
Just on the engage, fellas. No, we're not false. No, I'm not.
So it's Bay of Plenty
down
ball.
And hold. Come a bit closer. We're too far apart there. Crouch and hold.
Yeah, interesting
wait
call, right? I'm sure Bay of Plenty will take it, though.
Engage!
It's shut by the Lions, but now Bay of Plenty hold up nicely. Senior reaches in. Williams. Across to McCoy. Cashmore right beside him. Now he needs to get the ball to the ground and release it.
Hands off, tackler, Ridge!
It's there for the Bay, though. Senior has to have a second shot at it. Williams. Big defence coming over the top from Matt Stevens. Well, there's hands all over the place in there.
There's a penalty.
Yeah, it had to happen.
Hands.
Had to happen. You could see the hands in there quite clearly.
You can't come in and use your hands.
And there should be no arguments. And once again, it was Matt Stevens. Pretty young by proffing standards, just 22 years of age, born in South Africa. Kind of looks like a South African, doesn't he?
Drakey, they say this Martin Williams is one of the quickest players in terms of the loose forwards for the Lions. He was the Six Nations Player of the Year, voted by all the various pundits. But this fellow, Latu, is giving him a bit of a hurry up tonight. He's having a very strong start. Nearly Latu is giving away so much size.
Yep, thank you.
Well, they're working their way back into this Bay of Plenty. 17-0 down. Bears a strange resemblance to last night's All Black trial. There was a team ahead by 17 points to nil at one stage. Penalty has been made by Murray Williams, 17-10.
Well, they get the points, Bay of Plenty. I think they can consider themselves a wee bit lucky. A couple of knock-ons. Stay committed and went the other way. I think the penalty in the end was fair enough, but the pressure's building.
Lions have the advantage of a light breeze in the first half. As Colin Burke.
What time?
Lays it back. Senio. Well, they're a mile offside, these blokes. They're an absolute mile offside. And he's got them too. And so he should.
9-19.
They were so far offside, it was a joke.
Too early.
Smithy, I just wonder too, you know, things are not quite going their way. The interpretation of the ruck in the mall is going against the Lions. And they've just got to keep their composure and keep their chat. A lot of talk. You can just see them down the sideline. They're talking to the touch judges. They're talking to anyone who'll listen. But they've got to keep cool.
Yeah, I think you're right, Drake. And I just wonder sometimes when you see sides starting to infringe like they are and try to crib up extra ground, maybe they're just running out of steam a bit. They've had half an hour of football. They've had a big stoppage, 5 minutes of stoppage with the Delalio injury. But they're not looking as fresh as they were. That is for real.
Lawrence Delalio here is on his way to Rotorua Hospital for x-rays as Williams takes it up. Calling in all sorts of runners here, Bolobuthu, but he's nicely contained in centre field. But they've had all the ball lately, have Bay of Plenty. Here's Upton.
Hands off five.
5 metres on his own side of halfway, cleared off by Senio to Williams. Latu having a storming game, the little flanker, but he's lost the ball. And now the Lions have an opportunity. But it's a forward pass.
And the arms go up from the Lions. Just on that possession, Nisbo. I think it was, 84% to the Lions after the first 10 minutes. They're now at 39%. Oh, it has changed.
Wonderful work in there by O'Driscoll. This is the forward pass. And they weren't very happy about it. Gesticulations, it's almost like watching a preach. Senior from the scrum, Williams. Big bust by Bunter. Now, can he find some support? He's got Cashmore inside the 22.
Forward pass,
and a forward pass picked up there by Paul Honus as well. But okay, alarm bells in midfield as Alan Bunting went straight through.
Well, it was the angle, pure and simple. He came from a long way back. Hits at the angle, look at that, and he just chops it up. O'Gara's not going to get near him.
Well, O'Gara can't tackle. We've seen that already. Or won't tackle.
Cashmore did very well to get there, I thought.
Engage. Break up, fellas. Just pushing off the mark.
Well, the Bay of Plenty.
Wait till the ball comes in.
Take it a wee while to work out the weaknesses.
And over he comes.
On defence, this is one of them. Number 10, Ronan O'Gara. He's missed a few tackles.
Engage.
Pretty good scrum by the Bay of Plenty. They made it awkward.
About nine.
And Peel's kick is a shocker.
And Smithy, you get the feeling the crowd's a bit more excited at the moment.
Oh, they're into it now because they sense something a little bit special. And why shouldn't they? Because the game is going so much Bay of Plenty's way. But there's some key players starting to make some big errors on behalf of the Lions. Just the composure is going. I think that was a fair enough call too by Paul Honus. One apiece. Lineouts have come good.
Matui lobs it towards the back. Taken down by Burke. All spills clear for Senio. Williams now. Bunting. Oh, nice work. Tahana. Tahana's got support. It's Senio.
Roll off tackler.
Here they go again.
He had to give it, maybe.
Davidson crashing into the Lions. Now Latui. He's still got it, though. Here he goes.
Hands off, Reed Rock.
Looking to work the blind side with Williams. Williams! Williams is in!
By 10.
Well, you've got to take some risks if you're playing an international. And there's a lot of risks in this move. Right from way back with the backflip to McCoy. That was a 50-50 pass if you've ever seen one. Just look at this. From Bundings, look at that, no-look pass, and that made the space. That put them way above the advantage line. Senior does very, very well to get there so quickly. And the drive continues. I would have thought they could have freed it now and gone. This is the end of it. And I'll tell you what, for a young man, yes, I don't think he's ever played, or he might have played one or two first-class games for Auckland before he came down to the Bay of Plenty. He's adjusted pretty well, Smithy.
Yeah, somewhere around the world there's a bloke by the name of Glenn Jackson watching this, and he will have enjoyed every single moment of that flowing back movement. Remember, this side's only been back together for 5 days, so that kind of combination in midfield, that's gold. And so's that kick.
Quite remarkable, really. We're back to even Stevens. The Lions after 17-0. The Bay have battled back. It's 17 all. And Murray Williams has scored their second try.
And he slipped the skipper too, O'Driscoll.
Well, he's distributed the ball all night. I think he's been for one run and he got slammed. I don't think they're picking that he was going to step.
O'Gara kicks off. Sorensen waits. Boy,
come,
they're playing with some confidence now. A Bay of Plenty. Senio back to Williams. And what a good kick again. He's growing in confidence, the young fellow. He's played for New Zealand under-21s.
Well, he only came down this way because there's a bloke in Auckland called Spencer. Now, he thought he might go somewhere else.
Well, he used to be.
Yeah, well, that's right.
3 minutes remaining in the first half. Who would have believed it? Oh, that's hopeless.
Lifting early and walking.
Well, he warned them before. A bit of a how's your father here.
Hey, back off, back off.
Always good just before half-time, isn't it?
Well, a free kick for lifting early and walking the throw. Back to 15, back 10.
Well, he warned them before.
That was Ben Kay involved.
In, yeah, next time.
Ben Kay involved in that, Drakey, and I sort of assumed he'd taken over the leadership of the back after Delalio, so they are falling apart somewhat.
It was an indirect penalty, so they've gone for the scrum, which is interesting. Didn't want to kick it out, didn't want to tap it and run it up. Obviously got confidence in their backs, man on man. Let's see how they go. They've got a scrum first.
Well, confidence too in their scrum, Drakey.
Engage.
Which has been holding up pretty well.
Good hit from Castle. Bit of pressure from the Lions.
Worked out okay in the finish though, as Williams. Bunting right on the halfway line. And the ball turned over. And a chance here for the Lions. It was O'Connell. Now Henson, he gets smashed down in a tackle. And the Lions have got some ball finally after all this time. There was a no-look pass. And there aren't many blokes around who can do that properly. There's one who lives, as you say, in Auckland, Drakey. Get away with it now and again.
I think it was forward anyway, but he's trying to squeeze something before half time. They've done well. They've got the turnover, the Lions. But they haven't seen the ball for such a long time.
Crouch and hold.
Just didn't know what to do with it.
Closing in on half time at 17 each.
Another good hit from Castle on the side. He's locking the scrum up well.
Burt takes it off and...
Leave it!
They've got a bit of a Donnybrook on here.
That's full on. That's the two loose forwards, is it?
Back off.
I'm wondering if Latu blocked Williams. That's what I may be picking. And that gave Burt the clear run. We'll have a look at the replay, but they'll sort this out first.
Yeah.
Williams took exception, maybe, and I think he was going to penalise Latu anyway. Let's have a look. He might get in for retaliation. You can see Latu's holding on to him, trying to. So he does. That won't let him run. He gets whacked. But I tell you what, it might be reversed. He'll get him for retaliation. I know it's a crazy rule, but let's see.
You were holding him down. The ball had gone. You can't do that. You've retaliated with a punch. I'd seen it. If you hadn't punched him, the penalty wouldn't go against you. Okay? Keep your hands to yourself. Yeah. Penalty goes against Red.
Well, you're dead right, Draggy. It's gone against the Lions.
I tell you what, I don't like that rule. I know it's in the book, but it's always the guy who gets angry, gets in trouble. What's he supposed to do?
Williams is going to kick it out, and that's going to bring down the curtain on the first half. And what a first half it's been. 40 minutes that saw the Lions get out to a 17-0 lead, and then Bay of Plenty bounce back, and that is the half-time score, 17 each.
Oh, absolutely dramatic. The Lions started like you wouldn't believe, with precision up front, great running of backs and forwards, getting over the advantage line, had great continuity and showing a lot of pace out wide and good direction. After 10 minutes they were 17 up, and then it just fell away for them. The Bay slowly ground their way into it. They started to win a lot more ball. They changed their tactics a wee bit, got a bit of confidence, scored some remarkable tries, and they're back in this game well and truly. All to play for in the second half.
The Lions scored three tries in the first half. Bay of Plenty scored two. But at halftime in the tour opener, it's Bay of Plenty 17, the British and Irish Lions 17. Well, they've got a real spring in their step, the Bay of Plenty team. They were shell-shocked, and I think just about everybody was in the first 10 minutes. So the Lions really have got to start all over again.
Well, I was just going to say, good opportunity for them at halftime, just to get their composure, get their pattern back, just slow it down a wee bit, simplify what they're doing. Their line out and set pieces, get that back and working, and just set some targets up. Don't try and get too lateral, which I think they're probably guilty of. Hang on to the ball and build up some phases. If they can do that, they can certainly get back into it. Pretty simple to talk about. It's a bit different when you're out there, I guess.
Drakey, it's probably a weird thing to say, but for the sake of the long part of the tour and the test matches, the last 30 minutes probably did them more good than the first 10.
Yeah, I know what you mean, Smithy. It's probably brought them down to earth and realised if they had have just romped away with it, they might have got the wrong impression. They've certainly got the right impression at the moment.
Here we go then. Second half is underway, and the kickoff goes down to replacement Martin Corrie. And he's taken on the 22-metre line. And the ball turned over, but it's been
roll off and leave the ball alone. Goal,
handled
please.
On the ground by Bay of Plenty, and they concede an early penalty. And it might have been the skipper.
Well, it was just sitting there, and he just couldn't resist. The cut under his eye. He got that at training this week. No problem for him.
O'Gara with this early penalty kick.
There's Ormond there, he's all over the ball.
Stay on the white line, goal on the white line.
He's a tackler, he's on the ground, he can't do that. Good opportunity here for the Lions, set piece. They just want to win the line out, either drive it or chalk it up in midfield. Settle it down.
What a bullet throws. Quickly off the top it goes from O'Connell. Working it wide to Cueto. In comes Lucy. And some good defence out wide by Bay of Plenty. They did tend to crab across a little. No one straightening it.
Oh, gee, I don't know. I don't understand that, Smithy. Good ball. Settle it down in the first 10 of the second half. Just drive it up the middle and they go wide, very laterally.
And very laboured. The passing seemed to take forever to get across. They were using the width so well at the start of the first half.
That's because they had runners coming in and smashing up the middle, guys like Delalio, and getting a quick phase.
Deep throw, good one too, to Ormond. Senio putting a bit of pressure on Tom Shanklin. He did the job well on the finish. Got it back to Bullock, yeah, but the flag is up.
Good kick, good chase. Clever by Bay of Plenty. Jenkins does well. Yeah, there's the foot into touch.
Ernie Upton making the line-out calls, and he's made it to himself. Good throw again by Latui Williams. Bunting, who's cut through a couple of times in midfield for the Bay.
Release on the ground
a little bit
now.
Slow coming back here for Ormond. Needs some support, gets it from Upton. Now McCoy works it wide for Tahana. Top try scorer last year for the Bay, Anthony Tahana. Senio to Williams, lobbed into centre field. Burt releases nicely for Balabuthu. Now Latui took a while to drag it in, but he got it. And they're only 10 metres short of the line here, threatening once again. Balabuthu goes blindside. Now Sorensen, quick hands required. It's still alive, and it's picked up for McCoy. Got support there from Tahana. It's loose. It still hasn't been knocked on. Now the Bay.
He's fine.
Desperate to get this one back.
They turn over.
I don't think they will. The Lions have done well. O'Gara is going to kick. And a pretty useful kick too. He needed to settle it all down. He was outside the 22. But that is a good kick. And it takes the Lions deep inside the Bay 22.
And more importantly, they can start to put some pressure on Bay of Plenty. A lot of ball going to ground for Bay of Plenty. They're very lucky to get out of it. Too many drop passes. This is a two. Well, this could have been the longest dive towards the line you'd ever see, because he's just making the 22.
So defensive line out for the Bay. Oh, just about went over the top. Loose ball, knocked away. Williams has got a chance here for the Lions. Henson gets it wide, and Shanklin can't hang on. Big chance, and Tom Shanklin, he's a pretty good finisher. But he made a mess of it that time, and I think he's been given the word.
I'm going to chat. I'm wondering if the pass... Oh, no, well, that's... You just see the hands on O'Driscoll's head. That's what they wanted. They wanted that try. It's not over yet for Bay of Plenty, though. Under pressure at that last line out. Now they've got a scrum to contend with.
Crouching hold.
Pretty useful scrum. Oh, yeah. He's going backwards.
Holding. Yeah. Number six, Red, holding.
And Paul Honus has spotted, obviously, a Lions player holding back one of the...
Well, he must have been holding back Ormond, I'm wondering, because the move was from Burke to Ormond to wheel it round. Ormond took a long time to get there. I'm not sure about that.
No disputing it, though, from Richard Hill.
Drakey, Vern Cotter's about to go to the bench, and he's going to go for gold a bloke who's been itching to get out there.
Gold eight.
Paul Tupou in jersey 18.
Well, he's coming on, is it, for Burke? He's...
In fact, is it 19, is it? No, it is 18. Oh, that's Warren Smith, sorry.
Okay.
Jersey 19.
Interesting call. With just a few minutes gone in the second half. So Warren Smith is on. Senio pops a little kick in. Shanklin again called into action. Gets his pass off nicely this time to Lucy. Dragged down by Senio. And there it is for Peel. O'Gara doing a little more kicking here. And doing it pretty effectively. Kept in nicely by Cashmore. All that experience. And he's been around a long time, Adrian Cashmore. Started with the Bay in the early 90s. Left the Bay in 1993 to head up to Auckland. And then, of course, had a few seasons in Japan as well. Bullock throws. Tapped down nicely for Peel. O'Gara. Now it's with Henson. Henson gets his pass nicely off. Williams is there, the loose forward. Been snapped up though by the Bay. just had a few more players there. Dory trying to do his work over the top. Back now for Williams. And the clearance is made.
Well, they're hanging in by a plenty at the moment. You can just sense there's a wee bit more confidence. And a lot of great skills from Henson, wasn't it, to pick up the low pass. Off, good offloads.
Six goals.
We've got the line-out throw here. Full line-out. Oh, no, they've got a couple of loose forwards out the back.
Yeah, great work by Upton. Short throw by Bullock. And another probing kick by Senio. He's just got that little breeze behind him, Smithy, getting a little extra distance. Here goes Lucy on the counter-attack.
Hands off goal, Ruck.
All there for Peel. Now Bullock, the Scottish hooker. Most capped Scottish hooker of all time.
It's turnover, Nisbet.
And I think he might have lost it. No, it's back on the Lions side for Peel. Now Shanklin. Right on the halfway line. 8 minutes gone, second half. No change to the halftime score. Latu, he's like a little fox terrier. O'Gara, Henson, nails.
Hold.
Peel gets it back. O'Gara's going to have another kick. And skidding off this fairly wet surface. And he's made some good tactical kicks here in the second half.
Pretty clear, Smithy, what they want to do. They want to play it down the bay at plenty end of the field.
They do. They've got to look for territory and then go back to a game that they know so well in that part of the world. Just watching their backline moves from set pieces. They're running from very, very deep. Twice now we've seen little backhand flicks from O'Driscoll. I just wonder whether it's because they've got the timing wrong in the move.
Lions just closing that line up a little bit. Latui to throw. Comes back to the hooker. And so somehow, Bay of Plenty have managed it. Senio's kicking here has been very good. This time he's just lobbed it a bit in field. Cueto, though, has lost it behind him. Forced to kick.
Good call from Cashmore.
He was very sure that he wanted it. Laid it back nicely, Ormond. Now Williams. Here's the new man, Warren Smith. Here's Ormond, looking as though he might want to kick it. Then he tried to lay off the pass. But he was angling across field. He was a sitting duck. Williams clears it. O'Gara. Lucy. Good defend on Williams. Peel. Held up by his opposite number. O'Connell carries it on for the Lions. They're 10 out from the 22. Peel again. Another kick made by O'Gara. And he's lobbed it into touch. They'll have the line out on the 5-metre line.
It came from a turnover. Ormond was in two minds whether he's going to kick it or pass it.
Pua Stewart in jersey 22 for Bolavuthu, who's had a couple of darting runs out wide but hasn't created that much of an impression.
Pua Stewart played every game for Bay of Plenty last season. Might have been a little unlucky to miss selection in this game, but he's on pretty early. Half an hour remaining in the match.
Five, step out.
Another deep throw. Latu read it beautifully. It worked well for the Bay. Back for Williams.
Holding goal, stay.
Spiraling kick, Cueto. This time he's got it right. Out to the centre field to Lucy. Now Shanklin. O'Driscoll. Good tackle by Mark Sorensen. Now the Lions. O'Gara. O'Connell. Crunching defence in centre field by Bay of Plenty. Ball is there again for Peel. O'Gara. Lucy, they read it well, but he got the pass nicely off to Hill. And the veteran Englishman setting it up. O'Gara again. Shanklin. Shanklin, I think he's over. And the try is given. And the Welshman, Tom Shanklin. Tim Shanklin scores the second try, at least the first try of the second half.
Well, it was good pressure from the Lions. They got the turnover. Just got the pressure. They had too many numbers in the end. And for once, they were running very straight. You can just see that. Straight down the tram lines. His momentum was always going to take him over. They had plenty of squabble about it, Smithy, but that was a good try.
I think it was too, Drake, and I think you've summed it up quite nicely. The fact that they're actually running with purpose at players and setting players up outside them. Earlier on in the second half, they've not been doing that. They've just been floating aimless passes without getting players into better positions. And I think it was started by O'Driscoll's stinky footwork when they were in a bit of trouble, and they carried on from there.
Really, Bay of Plenty, they'll look at themselves, and they've had a fair bit of ball in the second half, but they haven't done much with it. So, a bit like the Lions, they're going to have to tighten it up a wee bit and just drive it through.
Difficult kick here for O'Gara. No joy for Ronan O'Gara. Well, Tom Shanklin, he's had a bit of a shaky match, but he finished that one well. This is the guy who scored against the All Blacks in Cardiff. Just comes up a bit short. Ooh.
Yeah, I just think it was momentum. He's going to slide over. The slow motion replay made it look a bit different.
Pickoff made by Williams. Corrie wants it. Happy to carry the ball up, and he does it pretty effectively too. He's a big man. Martin
Corrie.
There will be an opening there now with Delalio out for some time, one would imagine. Kick made downfield is taken by Cashmore. Hoists it high. It's on the Lions side, the Peel. O'Gara. It nice and low for poor Stewart, who can play fullback. There's a lovely looking kick. Maybe just didn't quite get the angles right. And Gavin Henson. Boy, that is a big punt. McCoy going back. Taking some time to get a hold of it. Now he gets the chance in this game of force back. That's a good kick too by McCoy.
Yeah, good settling down. So both sides now want to play it down the other end of the field. Lions will get this throw in, which is very important, so they can start again. And I just think they've settled down a wee bit. I haven't seen a lot of driving from line-out time from them, though. That's been interesting. Hopefully they can start bringing that a bit more, because that keeps the opposition a bit tighter than you'd expect.
A lot of shuffling going on in the lineouts. Putting their halfback under enormous pressure. Oh, Teddy been really competitive at the broken play. O'Gara's knocked it on.
Well, that came from a lineout, and there's Peel, and he won't be too happy. He should give his forwards a good flogging for that. They've got to set the ball up and drive it a wee bit. This is the end of it. O'Gara, he was just thinking about what was coming. Look at the eyes. He looks up there. He's Ben Castle and Wayne Orman. He's like, oh, no thanks.
Engage.
The chance here for the Bay. Senio. Williams. Long pass out to McCoy. Tahana. Making good ground, Anthony Tahana. Now they finally get him. He's made some excellent ground, carried on by Latu. Senio looking to go blindside, does so. Got the pass back inside to Upton.
Yeah,
and it went forward.
I think it went off prop. I think it was off Davidson. He didn't even know it was coming. Put a George Gregan there from Senio. It didn't work.
Either that or Wayne Orman might have just got a little hand on it at some point. But what a terrific run, getting low and just driving through O'Driscoll's tackle initially.
He's not the quickest winger going around, Anthony Tahana, but He's one of those guys who scores tries. He always gets over the advantage line. Latu's there. Well, he's been everywhere tonight.
He's had a huge game, hasn't he?
You're going to have nightmares about him, the Lions. Had a quiet Super 12, really, for the Waikato Chiefs. But I think he's the kind of player who's better on the field than as a reserve somehow.
16 minutes gone, second half.
Crouch and hold.
5 points in it.
Engage.
Dwayne Peel putting some real pressure. The scrum disintegrates. They might be lucky, though, the Lions.
Seven.
And they're going to have to get a clearing kick out of O'Gara. But we hear so much about the scrummaging power from the Northern Hemisphere. Well, I tell you what, they've been given a bit of a lesson in this one.
Oh, yeah, well, they just got squeezed around the corner there. Castle and Latui. Davidson just driving up the middle like a wedge.
Line out claimed by Warren Smith.
We went to ground. Went to ground, the tackle never released the ball and got up holding on to it.
Well, it's against Martin Williams.
And you'd have to say, Smithy, that's something they're going to have to sort out, the interpretation, and it's been very clear, you know, interpretation, it shouldn't be between the two hemispheres, but it's a couple of times tonight.
Well, you get the feeling too, if Delalio was out there, there'd be a lot more questions being asked of
Paul. That's right,
Paul
so Williams is on the ground there,
yeah.
And what, he's got up again and he's played the ball, and what Honus has said that you can't do that, well, Honus knows the rules, I guess, but... It's just a bit of confusion there.
The player that's been a bit quiet tonight for the Lions, although in the last 40 minutes or so he's been going backwards behind his back, is Dwayne Peel. You look at the difference between him and Kevin Senior, who's doing a lot of work from the base of the scrum and a lot of running, committing tacklers.
Here's Williams, penalty goal. And the margin down to 2 points again. 22 points to 20.
And that's important for Bay of Plenty. If you get down the red zone, we guess we can call it, you've got to take some points, and they've done that. That's very important. Look at the expression on Orman's face.
O'Gara's kickoff. Orman waiting. Ball is there for Senio. Williams. Nicely done by Bay of Plenty. Beautifully
huge
done,
kick.
In fact. Beautifully worked.
Well, he's been ice cool, this bloke, tonight. I wondered about him before the game, but he hasn't done much wrong. Starting to talk a bit too, that's always a good sign, Smithy.
Yeah, it is. He'll catch on. This is Gordon Bullock. He's under a bit of pressure. He may have spied Steve Thompson doing a bit of warming up on the sideline. It looks like Survive's going to go to the bench in that department. He may not have been happy about that last scrum. The lineouts, the timing of the jumpers,
can't
the
have players in here getting a call, then retiring 10 metres. They've got to all stay in, OK?
This is an area
penalty,
that I've really
Smithy.
Got to work
checking
on, isn't
now.
It?
Going to ping
numbers
or not?
As they stand now.
No. OK.
One more.
Ben Kay drops it off to Bullock, and Turner goes to Hill.
Leave it, goals.
Peel, O'Gara works it on. Ensign, off the side of the boot, and he's very disappointed with that kick.
Well, he tried to kick it a lot. He's got a huge boot on him. He's natural left footer, so it was going to be handy for them. Right footer, and just slide it off. He's not happy. He's better than that.
Getting pretty frustrated with themselves, I think, the Lions. 20 minutes remaining in the game. Match up for grabs. Upton again. Senio can see there's a run on here, and away he goes.
Good tackle, Hill.
Always a reliable player, Richard Hill. He'll never let you down. Davison. Here's Latu. Senio again. Back on the inside. He wasn't expecting it, though.
Take the first knock on.
Adrian Cashmore. Well, he might have been expecting it, but it was a high pass.
Down
yeah,
here,
it was
ball.
Forward anyway, I think so. They don't have to do that, Bay of Plenty, I think. Just keep the momentum going. This is pretty good ball. He heard the call. Oh, no.
Wait a minute.
Opportunity here.
Scratch and hold.
The Lions, and I think they'll try and go downtown.
Engage.
Corey goes for a run. That's the halfway line just to the right. Peel. Now they set it up for O'Garrett to make the kick, and there's another raking kick downfield. And he's done it pretty well once again, Ronan O'Gara. And you're tempted to say, aren't you, that the Lions have, after this initial start, have reverted to type.
Yep, well, I don't blame them. They're under stress, under pressure. Corey did well. He took the defence one way. That just lets O'Gara in the pocket. He can go downtown. Pressure again on the Bay of Plenty line-out, which has worked reasonably well since the first 10 or so minutes.
Latul. His line-out throwing has been excellent tonight, with very few exceptions. That time it was Sorensen. Senio's had a very strong game at halfback. And although he doesn't quite get the distance this time, his kicking has been excellent.
Okay, two changes now. We are going to see Paul Tupai on in jersey 18. And also Tafa'osa Felisi is on. And he'll take the place of Sims Davison. And he'll go into lock for Mark Sorensen, Paul Tupai. So some energy that's been waiting to be released. Jakey.
Oh, yeah, we'll just let the pictures tell the story, Smitty.
O'Connell takes it down. Very nearly made a mess of it, but now they're under control. Henson, he's got O'Driscoll with him. And the ball is sitting there saying, pick me up. And that's exactly what Senio tried to do, although he knocked it on.
Come down, red ball.
So no ball protection there at all.
Senio, he's down. Is he all right? Or maybe upset. Fell awkwardly. Good opportunity for the Lions here. Scrum, they can go both ways. Look at this.
Engage.
Well, Vern Cotter's gone to the bench. He's made his
advantage.
Impact is an advantage playing here. I think offside against Bay of Plenty.
Here's leading the scrum early.
Chance now for the Lions. Oh, whipped away for Lucy. Getting it wide for Cueto. Williams clears it away for O'Gara. Boy, they're flying up here, Bay of Plenty. O'Connell, the big lock forward from Ireland, takes it in. Now Peel having another go. Not sure whether the advantage still applies or not. It's a long one.
He said it's gone.
It's gone, has it?
Hold. Hands off, goals.
Plenty of options available here. O'Driscoll. Now it's Corey. Just swarming all over them in defence. Peel. O'Gara. Thought about a kick, then held on. Tahana's stolen it. And Senio clears. Good work by the winger.
Tahana, was it? Well, they're going backwards and forwards, and you said it in his boat. He couldn't breach it. Felisi did the original tackle, which turned the Lions player. Dana goes in and saves it. They're still under pressure, though. They are plenty.
Two changes for the Lions. Sandy Sheridan in jersey 17 for Matt Stevens. And Steve Thompson on and hooker for Gordon Bullock.
Well, two huge players. Here's Corey off to Thompson. They're in touch. Steve Thompson is a massive hooker. We've seen him before, of course, with England.
Just on the chalk, was it?
Just did too, yeah.
He's a huge man. I'll tell you what, he'll cause some trouble at scrum time. More of a prop than a hooker.
Sheridan is a massive man too. Not a good throw. It's gone to Latu of all people. And Senior has to tidy up. Now here's Ben Castle. He's had a strong game. Laying it back nicely. There's a bit of grunt in that Bay of Plenty forward pack. Kick made by Williams, cleverly done, right in between the two of them. Shanklin having to get back, and he's going to kick it himself. and he does a pretty good job as Cashmore fields it.
That's great play from Bay of Plenty forwards. The throw went wrong. It went to Lado. He gave it to Senio. Senio started by just driving up the middle, and then they just rumble at 20 or so metres. Kind of play you'd kind of expect from the Lions, Smithy, not the Bay of Plenty team.
He's had a very strong game, a big influence on the turnaround that has Kevin Senio. He's been darting. He's been not scared to take the forwards on. Russell up a few yards. Very, very strong game.
Latui, just a little short of Upton, but they've got it now. It's been stolen away by Hill, who's had a strong match tonight. Richard Hill, he's had some real injury problems in the last few years, but he still looks to be a huge competitor. O'Driscoll having a go. He's got through this time, but he's got some support on field, and he throws a poor pass. Lucy up to Shanklin, forward pass.
Away. I thought it was O'Driscoll was a forward pass, and I think he got the call from Steve Walsh. It was a late call. Interesting to see. Just on the outside, Bunting, he's got enough pace and skill to get round him. I thought that pass there floated forward, definitely.
Here's our mark, hookers. Wake up, over the mark.
This is great play from Hill. This is great skills. Look at that.
Gratchen holds. Sorry. No ball.
Well, he might be 32 years of age, Richard Hill, but there's still plenty of petrol left in the tank. Number six on this side.
Gratchen holds.
The man from Saracens.
Engage. Wasn't steady, fellas.
Some new faces in the front row.
Yeah, and Thompson obviously is going to be an important one. Yeah. He's going to be trying to drive through and really squeeze.
Crouch and hold.
Bay of Plenty front row.
Engage.
Taken off the back by Smith. And another towering punt downfield. Guido's keen to go quickly, does so. Those throws are supposed to be straight, they very rarely ever are. There's Henson, bouncing his way out of a few tackles.
Leave it!
There it is for Dwayne Peel. Guido got in close, Shanklin.
Hands off, ruck.
Peel once more, O'Gara. And once again, he's done it nicely. Certainly works the angles well. 2-point advantage for the Lions. 12 minutes remaining.
Blue two. And 12
and he's
red,
playing test match football, red. Just squeezing. When they get a roll on, he's content to let it go. But when they're static and when it just slows down and he sees the Bay of Plenty defence up, he's happy to put it into the corner.
So a new hooker on for Bay of Plenty in this boat. It's John Pariunga. Also, Gordon Darcy has gone on for the Lions in replacement of Gavin Henson.
Not straight, option red, scramble line.
Well, the first throw was shaky. So Darcy into midfield, clearly not straight.
Henson holds. Engage.
So the Irishmen coming together on midfield now with O'Driscoll and Darcy.
Off in the case, you get some new guys in the front row and they're all trying to prove themselves. He goes a bit wobbly.
Engage. No, goal, hold your weight.
Taken quickly by Corrie.
We'll take it at the back of the scrum.
Here, please.
Could go on forever.
I'll go to penalties, guys, if you keep doing it.
Yeah, they've got to be careful. Bay of Plenty. And I think he's pointing at Felici on this side. There he is there. I think he's saying you're wedging in.
I'll go to penalties.
Boring in.
Hold it steady. Crouch and hold. Engage.
Oh, that was a golden oldie scrum there.
Rebound.
Laurie wants to bring it out of the back.
Use it!
Now it's away with Peel. Peel opens up and oh, it's easy. The Welshman goes in and gets the try. We're all set up by the scrum. And the try scorer was Dwayne Peel.
Well, they worked that very well. They milked it. That scrum was the same as the two previous ones. Honus didn't do anything about it. And it was Wayne Orman, the Bay of Plenty skipper, who just slips here. When they're coming round, you'll just see him now. He just slips over. He's on the ground there, Orman. He went too wide. He couldn't adjust the angle. The little man Peel goes in, and that's a vital try for the Lions.
Yeah, the Lions have come good, haven't they, in the last 10 minutes or so. It's a good sign for them. They've withstood a lot of Bay of Plenty pressure, and because of the fact that O'Gara's been kicking the corners, working the corners, the game is starting to come together again. Good scrum. And this, well, another wayward kick.
Oh, that's a shocker.
Well, it's kept the margin at 7 points. That was a pretty important conversion attempt. But here is the try. He didn't have a hand laid on him in the finish.
Orman, he went too wide. It was his man. It was a wobbly old scrum. I think they manipulated it pretty well, the Lions. Corey did well at the back.
So the kickoff with 9 minutes remaining. It falls for Sheridan. Andy Sheridan, this huge man. Tino's got himself offside, and in the meantime, I think he's got cramped at the same time. Started to run, then suddenly pulled up.
Just hope that's all it is.
Place kicking aside, O'Gara has just been a little stronger in the second half, dictating the terms for the Lions, playing the game in the areas they really want to play them, in the corners.
Yes, he does. He looks a good player, Smithy, when he doesn't have to tackle. Held in the back by Richard Hill. Hands it back.
Collapsing at goals.
And that's not back 10 metres.
No, no, let me make the mark first. You can't take it before I've made the mark. 10, 6. Back it up.
So he didn't take it from the mark. Norman will be relieved about that.
Again, clever play from the Lions. They went for a drive at line. Haven't done a lot of that tonight. Last time was way back in the first half and they got sacked straight away. Bay of Plenty didn't do that. They got the drive on, then they collapsed it. Concede the penalty, so they're just squeezing. You can just see the experience is coming out from the several key players for the Lions. As you'd expect, Bay of Plenty, well, they've got to get their hands on the ball.
Steve Thompson to throw. O'Connell gets up high.
Truck and trailer.
And it's a truck and trailer call.
I don't know if they've heard about that up north, Nisbo.
They got enough of them on the M1, they should have.
Dead right. They haven't conceded too many penalties in the second half, the Lions. Only two, in fact, in the entire second spell.
Yeah, so it's been good discipline. I'll try and upset this line out.
Harianga to throw. Again, dragged down by the Lions, so the new hooker not having much luck with his throwing in. Kicking through. There's O'Driscoll, and they've certainly worked it out in the second half. And obviously the message was drummed into them at half time. We're going to play this game in the opposition 22.
Well, clearly beaten at the front of the line out. That Ormond, I think he'd moved up the front. Bit of pressure.
I need to get this one right, Bay of Plenty.
And a full line out.
Again, it's been came up short and was tipped by O'Connell. So the Lions getting some free ball here.
Out 18, out.
Corey driving hard. O'Connell. Now Peel, drop kick here from O'Gara. And he's pushed that one wide too, trying to make up for the conversion that he missed, just to take it outside that seven-pointer. But it remains a seven-point margin as the long kickoff goes straight down to Lucy. Now Cueto gets it straight down to McCoy. He in turn sends it off downfield to be holding his breath here. It doesn't go dead. Oh dear, yes it will. So it's a long way back.
Hit it too well.
Okay. Yeah, okay. 11 red. Which side is 11 red? Time off. 11 red is going off, I think. Yeah, swing it on. Thank you.
Or changes, Smithy.
Time on, yeah, please. Matt Dawson, familiar face to all of us, Nisbah, in jersey 20.
Yep.
And I think we'll find that made way for it. Tom Shanklin's made way for him, so he's going to go on the wing, Matt Dawson.
Break up. What's going on, guys? What's number 20 doing on here?
Good point, Paul Harness.
Fellas, control a bit, please.
So is Peel going to the wing?
Okay.
Shanklin standing on the touchline on the halfway on the far side.
Bingo.
Peel's gone onto the wing, so Dawson's obviously not a sprinter anymore. Good scrum. Lions.
Nicely controlled as Dawson gets it off to O'Gara. Big get for Josh Lucy, and a lovely try will be scored by Gordon Darcy, and the Lions are finishing right over the top of this game, and that was beautifully worked, and that secures the victory for them.
It was a great try, and they've been drifting across field all night, well certainly after the first 10 minutes, and this time they didn't. It was a straight player running dead straight which did it. The decoys were on the outside, but they'd already chopped up the Bay of Plenty defence. Darcy finished it off. But look at this. Opened up the Bay of Plenty midfield. There's no way Cashmore could do anything about it. The damage was done. That's a good try from the Lions. Well worked. And that came from a lot of pressure. From a set move. From the kick from McCoy, which went too far. So they've just squeezed Bay of Plenty out of this game.
Well, I know now that the two pieces of bread are under control of the Lions, just the meat and the sandwich, which was a bit ordinary in the middle part of the game. They have started and finished quite brilliantly. Lovely back line move, and whenever Lucy has become involved running from the back, he has looked dangerous.
Yes, that was a good pass from O'Gara again. You can just see O'Driscoll and co. taking the defence just slightly wide, and that was enough.
Smiles all round. Josh Lucy has had a strong game at fullback. Now here's the Lions with a chance, and Sheridan gets to stretch the legs. Ball might have been lost forward there though. And it's grabbed by Bay of Plenty. Not sure whether he was playing advantage or not, Paul Honus.
Yes, he was, I think.
So Bay of Plenty with some ball here as Williams gets his pass off. Back. And a brave performance by the Bay of Plenty. They're going to come up short, but they've certainly given the Lions a taste of New Zealand rugby. It won't be an easy 6 weeks for them. As Williams struggles his way a few metres.
Hands are on, play on.
McCoy off to Orman. Orman trying to set up his winger. And Wayne Peel, who started at halfback, now playing out on the left wing side. So just a minute or so remaining in the tour opener. The Lions are going to get home after they were tied up 17 each at half time. Ormond, now Senior, who's had an excellent game. Cashmore gets it quickly to Tahana. Kick and chase. Lucy waits. And the ball is in touch.
That was a lovely kick. Lucy's a bit upset. Tahana thought, well, such a good kick, I might as well come and say hello.
Hey, settle down.
Exactly, Paul Honus sums it up. Hopefully they'll have a beer with each other in 10 minutes.
That's if they're not heading back to Auckland, 10 minutes after the game ends.
Short line out, time for a bit of pressure. Well done by Plenty, upset it a wee bit.
There goes the siren, and Matt Dawson happy to kick it into touch. And that is the first match all over. It's been highly enjoyable, it's been highly competitive. The Lions have finished just a little bit too strongly though for Bay of Plenty. It was 17 all at half time. The Lions have pulled away in the second half to get the victory by 34 points to 20.
Yeah, and I think a well-deserved victory. It came at a wee bit of a cost when they lost to Alio. Brian O'Driscoll, he'll be happy. Second half, I think they played with a bit more composure. Tactically, they were better. They just put the ball into the corners, took advantage of turnovers from Bay of Plenty, who were outstanding in certain phases of the game. There's Ladu, he had a big game. They hustled and bustled, and they made the most of their opportunities, Bay of Plenty. They came up short at the end, and I guess that was just a wee bit of experience, which the Lions have showed. But the tour has started, and boy, Lions know they're in New Zealand, and we play footy.